probably noticed that we've been talking an awful lot about fractions around here lately. Well, now I'm going to tell you something you can do with fractions that's really easy. No, no, not juggling fractions. Although that is pretty easy for me. I'm talking about something even easier than that. I'm talking about multiplying fractions. Multiplying fractions is super easy. In fact, it's easier than adding fractions, and that's why we're going to learn it first. The reason it's easier is because fractions are really just division problems, and multiplication and division get along much better than addition and division. Now, since fractions are division, that means if I have the problem 1/4 times 2/3, it's the same as the problem 1 divided by 4 times 2 divided by 3. That means I have both multiplication and division in the same problem. And because they get along so well, that means I can just rearrange our problem to look like this. Now it looks like two multiplication problems that are being divided. And it looks just like a fraction. In fact, if we go ahead and do the multiplications, 1 times 2 equals 2, and 4 times 3 equals 12, then we do have a fraction, and it's the answer to our problem. So what does all this mean? Well, it means that to multiply fractions, all you have to do is multiply the top numbers, and then multiply the bottom numbers, and ta-da! There's your answer. As always, let's see an example or two. Let's try this problem, 2/3 times 4/5. Now, we could rewrite the problem like we just saw, but that's not necessary as long as we remember the procedure. First, we know our answer is going to be a fraction, so let's go ahead and write a new fraction line for it. Next, we multiply the top numbers. 2 times 4 equals 8, so 8's the top number of our answer. And last, we multiply the bottom numbers. 3 times 5 equals 15, so 15 is the bottom number of our answer. There we have it. 2 over 3 times 4 over 5 equals 8 over 15. See how easy that was? And fun, too. Even funner than video games. Okay, time for another example. Let's try 6 over 11 times 7 over 8. From our multiplication table, we know that 6 times 7 equals 42. So 42 is the top number of our answer. And on the bottom, we have 11 times 8, which is 88. So 6 over 11 times 7 over 8 equals 42 over 88. Oh, now some of you might see that this answer could be simplified, but we'll save simplifying fractions for another video. All right, let's see one last example. Here it is. 1/2 times 4 over 3 times 3 over 5. Wait a minute. This has three fractions multiplied together, and the middle one looks like an improper fraction because its top number is bigger than its bottom number. Does our procedure work for this problem too? Yep. All we have to do is multiply all the top numbers together, and then multiply all the bottom numbers together, and we'll have our answer. And this will work no matter how many fractions we have to multiply. So on the top, we have 1 times 4 is 4, and 4 times 3 is 12. And on the bottom, 2 times 3 is 6, and 6 times 5 is 30. That means our answer is 12 over 30. So there you have it. Multiplying fractions is easy because fractions are just another way of writing division problems. But remember, there's another way to think about fractions. We can also use fractions to represent parts of things, like half a pizza, for instance. But does it make sense to multiply half a pizza by another half? Actually, it does. If you're thinking of fractions as parts of something, then multiplying fractions is really like taking part of another part. For example, here's half a pizza. Now you can see that if I take 1/2 of that half, then I get 1/4 of a pizza. And if we do the multiplication 1/2 times 1/2, you see that we do get 1/4. So that's why you can think of multiplying fractions as taking part of another part. In fact, sometimes, especially in word or story problems, you'll see multiplying fractions written using the word of instead of times. They may ask, what's 3/4 of 2/3? And now you know they just mean, what's 3/4 times 2/3? So, whether you think of fractions as parts of something or as division problems, the procedure for doing the multiplication is exactly the same. Let's do a quick review of what we've learned. Multiplying fractions is even easier than adding fractions. It's easy because order of operations says that we can do the multiplication before the division. The The procedure for multiplying fractions is to multiply the top numbers to get the answer's top number, and multiply the bottom numbers to get the answer's bottom number. If you think of fractions as parts of something, then multiplying a fraction by another fraction is the same as taking a part of a part. And sometimes, especially in word problems, you might see the word of instead of the word times. Even though multiplying fractions is so easy, it's a good idea to practice. So be sure to do the exercises, and I'll see you next time. Learn more at mathantics.com.